I was watching Greg M. Porter's video. He was putting stickers, garage gang stickers, on his lockers. And gave me an idea. I've actually got three sets of two here. And they're actually one, two, three, four, five, and six. I think I'm going to sell five and six. That's what I think I'm going to do. They're neat because you open the door and you hit the switch. The apartment above opens. Open this locker and that apartment compartment opens. Kind of neat. Got these at the Amish auction. As it turns out, this set of lockers is six of over 200 lockers that came out of this place. How cool is that, It's a neat poster. So I might do a carbon fiber paint job on one set. Maybe do a flip-flop color or pack it up and send it to Tommy Shoe for a boat flake paint job. Who knows? Yeah, I'll probably keep one through four. Five and six will be for sale. Dig old lockers. Now what I'm looking for is a post office boxes. I'm looking for those. This is for a slow SRT. This is my slow SRT. 10. I think that's what yours is. Same color there. I don't even remember what year mine is. 05. Not a Mustang in town to touch it. Or a Camaro. Anyway. Time for dinner. I think I'm having meatloaf. I should be in here working, damn it. This is all stuff from inside the house for packing up and moving once the place sells. All I know is my next place better have a garage as big as this or bigger. I will not be a happy camper. Let me know if anybody interested in those two lockers. Come apart here. They're about, every bit of 6 feet, 8 inches tall. I'll let you know for sure. Wait a minute. That roller is 72 inches tall. This is just about 79 inches tall. Big boy. They are. How deep are they? Let's see here. Almost 18 inches deep. This is the fiberglass side. That's my back door. Open that door and that faces Jackass's farm. Bam Margera's place. Well, I was going to lay this up, but the tenants that live in the apartment upstairs are home. I don't want to stink them out, so I guess I have to do this tomorrow. Oh well. I guess you don't get to watch it tonight. Sorry, guys. Man, I need some tagamin or something. The wife made meatloaf. Decided to stop down and see my mom, look in my old shed. Now it's full of Harleys. I can't tell you how many frames and front ends I got. Just ton of stuff. All my chopper frames. I got hardtails, I got rigids, I got a drag bike. I got an 8-second drag bike right here, buddy. That's my 8-second Sportster. That's a bad boy. Can't see it through all the seats. They're all seats, man. Just Harley part after Harley part after Harley part. Tommy Shoe, you might recognize this little building. This is the building we were installing that big block in one of our race cars. It's empty now. I mean, it's so full now, you can't move. There's so much junk in here now. Good Lord. I mean, it's loaded to the top. I'd like to pull that bad boy out again, take it down the track this summer. Well, I can't even get back in here to find what I was looking for. I was looking for my solo seat. Front ends. Hell, where the hell's my light? There you go. Now you can see. Look at all the frames I got. Swing arms. Handlebars. Frames. Wheels. I got frames in the back. I got so many Harleys, it's not even funny. It's probably going to be my next chopper project right there. I don't know if you can see the frame or not. I think that might be it. Can't remember who even made that frame. It's a single down tube, as you can see. Can you see my race bike back in there? No, you can't even see it. Alright. Let me go in and say hi to Mom. Nothing but car show plaques. Turn it right out. Nothing but car show plaques. Air car show. Right there. Wow. Wonder what year it starts at back here. I can't even see. Alright, you can't really see anything here until I pull my chopper out, or my race car, or my race bike. And still can't see it from out here. Oh well, that's the kickstand right there. It's a bad boy. The deal was I was going to restore them. As I, when I retired and quit, I was going to spend my time restoring them, making choppers, making stockers. There you can see part of the motor. I wish you could see the whole thing. That thing is so bad, man. I'm going to pull it out of there. I'm not going to do it tonight, but I'm going to pull it out of there. There's my wheelie bars. Right there. This damn sun. Enough. I was going to start restoring them. But you guys got me fiberglassing. It's all your fault. Just kidding. I appreciate you appreciating me. I can't even tell you what's in here. I think that's my knucklehead in there. Alright, let me get on down the road. I gotta get to the shop, the big shop. They need me to sign off on a job and show them what to do or in how, what order to do it. You guys are gonna get something I said I'd never show anybody.
Stood there boldly, sweating in the sun. Felt like a million, felt like number one. The height of summer, I'd never felt that strong. Like a rock, I was 18, didn't have a care. Working for peanuts, not a dime to spare. But I was leaning solid everywhere, like a rock.
See the a small inside peak.
My hands were steady, my eyes were clear and bright. My walk had purpose, my steps were quick and light. And I held firm to what I felt was right, like a rock, like a rock. I was strong as I could be, like a rock. Nothing ever got to me, like a rock. I was something to see, like a rock. Stood arrow straight, unencumbered by the weight of all these hustlers and their schemes. I stood proud, I stood tall, high above it all. I still believed in my dreams. I wonder sometimes where they've gone. And sometimes late at night, oh, when I bathe in the firelight, the moon comes.
Into the heart of me.
Well, the rain stopped, thank God. I'm up on my feet, I'm around, I'm feeling good, I feel like a new man. I think I'll start off by spraying the truck bed liner inside the tour pack first. Get that going, let it start drying, and go over and work on the arrow. Now the arrow went from straight to being curved. But you'll see. All right, I do a little work on here. I have to sand that down, make it smooth, make it pretty. Take that puck off of there and tape it up and start spraying. I just want to give a piece of advice to a few of you who are out there getting ready to make molds. I've noticed there's about 7 of you getting ready to make some pretty good sized molds, but very common molds. You told me you wanted to do it because you wanted to make a mold. Okay. You need to take a few things into consideration. One, you have to store the mold. You have to store it properly or you'll ruin the mold. Okay, and there's a couple tricks to that. I can explain them to you if you go ahead on with the projects, but there's a guy out there making a Corvette hood. You know who you are. That hood that you're getting ready to make a mold of is going to cost you about $1,000 in materials. I can't tell you how many hours it's going to take. But the hood that you're making, according to my fact sheet, my order list, there's over 3,500 people right now making the same hood. Already have the molds, and they're dirt cheap. Okay? And there's a guy making a 55 Chevrolet one-piece front end. Get ready to make a mold out of it. Okay? I've got 2 of those molds up in the sheds. There's about 700 or 800 people making that same part. They price anywhere from $399 to $800. I'm just trying to save some of you some money there. But it's not cheap. Fiberglass is not cheap. There's a gentleman out there getting ready to make a whole body out of a Camaro, 69 Camaro. thinks it's going to be the only Camaro. He's going to sell a million of them. I don't want to break your bubble, but I can give you the addresses and telephone numbers of three manufacturers of Camaro bodies right now. Complete bodies. You can buy the whole car. Just trying to give you some good, honest advice. That's part of the YouTube Garage Gang, and that's my duty to let my brothers know what the real deal is. We have a steel building. I believe it's 60 by 80. Or maybe it's 40 by 80. From one end to the other, it's filled with molds. From full bodies, front clips, deck lids, hoods, doors, you name it. Every make and model you can think of. We never go in there. Every year, there's less and less cars and less people that want the fiberglass parts. Because there's less and less cars. You know, and those that do, don't want to pay the price. Well, I've shot my 2 cents again. So let's make that 4 cents. Let me get ready to tape this thing off. And I'm going to sand this little part here. Tape this off. And try this cheap-ass Rust-Oleum bedliner. And see how it works. This stuff stinks to high heaven. I'm going to drive for 72 hours, see how it looks. I don't like it. The insides came out beautiful, man. Absolutely beautiful. Just as sweet as could be. Nice hard shell finish. Can't tell that you really can't tell that the clear is on there, but it's on there. I mean, it's shiny. I don't know if you can pick it up in the camera though. Yeah, I guess you can, maybe. Yeah, there you go. You can see the camera shadow in it. Now all I have to do now is put all the cut. All I have to do now is let it dry real good. Put the hardware together, and she's done. Well, the inside anyway. I have to take it up the street here and have my man either spray it black for me, or I'll get some birch white and match it. I'll either match it or clash it. Clash it with black, match it with birch. Go. What the hell? Put some trunk paint right over top of it. It's supposed to dry to this look. Like it's supposed to look like. We'll see. We will see. Ready to see something crazy? Get ready to spray this in next. Did you really think I was just going to put bed liner in there and leave it like that? There you go. I'll tell you why I did what I did. I used this product simply because it has acetone in it. Acetone reacts with fiberglass, especially raw fiberglass, and this is the raw side. So when I sprayed that in there, it etched so hard into the fiberglass, you'll never, ever get it off. The stone surface here, this Valspar stone, also has acetone in it. And it etched into the bed liner. Now I'll spray this with a clear that has acetone in it, which will also etch into the paint. This will never come off. Now, sometimes you spray fiberglass with paints, paint flakes off. As it moves, as it gets hot, it just chips away, flakes off in big pieces. Not on the gel coat side, I'm talking about the raw fiberglass side. It doesn't look bad. In fact, I think it looks quite good. Quite good indeed. Good coat of clear. Should be ready for service. I'll sell it first. I got two offers already, so. Tour pack for sale or trade. Dries, I'll pull it off. You'll see the label again. I just shot three coats of clear. The insides came out beautiful, man. Absolutely beautiful. Just as sweet as could be. Nice hard shell finish. Really can't tell that the really can't tell what the clear is on there, but it's on there. I mean, it's shiny. I don't know if you can pick it up in the camera, though. Yeah, I guess you can, maybe. All I have to do now is let it dry real good. Put the hardware together. And she's done. Well, the inside, anyway. I have to take it up the street here and have my man either spray it black for me, or I'll get some birch white and match it. I'll either match it or clash it. Clash it with black, match it with birch.